The IHSAA Champions Television Network pleased to bring you coverage live of the 2011 Girls State High School Basketball Championship. Jerry Baker here along with Jane Schott. Welcome into the Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne. You see the 3A matchup. You saw that on your screen. That's what we're getting set for right now, Jane. And this is interesting because Benton Central is a ball club that hasn't been here for, well, what, since 89, I guess it was. And, of course, for the opponents, Evansville Memorial, it's been about 5 or 6 years for them. So we get a couple of newcomers here.
New faces on the floor. None of these players have ever played in a state championship for basketball, so it's going to be very exciting tonight.
Let's take a look and show you how these teams got here. The travel route, if you will, first off for Benton Central. They won the Frankfort Sectional, then the Rensselaer Central Regional, and then they had a battle with Fort Wayne Concordia, the number 14 team of the state. Their average win margin, though, has been very impressive, Jane. Almost 17 points per game for Benton Central as far as the winning margin is concerned. How about the keys for this ball club?
Well, they are a very, very good basketball transition team, so they're going to try to push the tempo as much as they can, but they've got to rebound the basketball to do that, and that's going to be tough against a very big and strong Evansville Memorial team.
Very hard to pick out a key player, if you will, for Benton Central because they have three that average a double figures, one of which is Cassidy Deno at 11-9, Hillary Moore at 12-3, but maybe the motor that makes this machine go is Caitlin Tolan.
No question. She really runs this team very well. As a sophomore, you wouldn't know that she is only a sophomore as their point guard. As Caitlin Tolan goes, so goes their team.
David Baxter is the head coach of the Benton Central Ball Club. Tonight he is going for win number 100. Wouldn't that be very, very special? Just a couple of minutes ago, he talked with our Jeremiah Johnson.
Looking forward to this Class 3A state championship game with David Baxter of Benton Central. And coach, I know this is a goal when the season started. Is it hard to believe you, all the hard work, all the practice, you're here at this point ready to compete for a state championship?
It is tough to believe, you know, but sitting here talking with you, seeing the Memorial players warming up behind us, just a tremendous opportunity. We're proud that we're able to participate in this game.
Little pregame X's and O's. You know, Emily Ladd's going to be a focal point, but I mean, what do you think the key is to stop Memorial?
The key for us is going to be, can we keep them off the offensive glass? As you know, they're a very strong team, post-dominated team. That's going to be big for us. And then can we get out and get some easy transition baskets?
You're a young team. We've seen a lot of seniors in the morning games. I know you've got, you know, a little experience, but this is a youthful, energetic group.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We hope that pays off for us. They may not know any better.
All right. Well, congratulations on getting here. And good luck today.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, the opponents for the Bison had a long trip up today. They came up from Evansville, actually came up yesterday. The Tigers, a ball club that comes in with a terrific record. They're going to have their hands full with Benton Central, but likewise the other way around. Here's the way that the Evansville Memorial Tigers won their way into Fort Wayne here at the Coliseum today. They had to beat the number 8 team in the state in the sectional. That was Gibson Southern, and that was one of the weirdest games ever. We'll talk more about that. 21-9, the final. They won the Jasper Regional. Then last week, beat a very good Roncalli team, number 10 of the state, 69-50. They have really rolled, Jane, in the tournament. Average win margin over 21 points a game. How about the keys for the Tigers?
Well, the keys for them is they've got to establish their inside game. They've got terrific post players led by Mallory Ladd, and that will be very important for them to get some nice, easy baskets early on. But the other thing is they've got to handle the pressure. Benton Central's probably going to make it a full court game, so if Evansville can handle that pressure, they'll be able to get that inside post presence established.
You mentioned Mallory Ladd. Likewise, Evansville Memorial with three players in double figures, Natalie Cohlmeyer and Anna Hackert. But it is Mallory Ladd that makes this team go.
A kid that averages a double-double, almost 23 points a game and 12 rebounds. She is a force to be reckoned with inside. I'm anxious to see her play.
Well, it's also anxious to see the head coach of this Evansville Memorial team. Bruce Dockery came up for a meeting on Monday with all the other coaches in the Final Eight. When he got home, he had an appendicitis attack. He got through the operation. He is here, and he is with JJ.
Well, Bruce Dockery has a smile on his face. I'm not sure that was the case Monday at about midnight. First things first, how are you feeling, Coach?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm a little tired, but, you know, who would miss this? It's great.
This is going to be a week you'll remember for quite some time. Was there a doubt ever about you being here to coach?
I think when they first told me, that's the first thing that came through my mind, but they reassured me that they thought the way it was going to play out, that I'd be fine, I'd be here.
Tell me about this. I mean, I know this was the goal all season to get to this point. You've played a tough schedule. You've been, you know, bullseye on your back all season, and they've answered every challenge.
this is a very special group. You know, win or lose, their focus and their intensity has been the same since day one. And they work hard and they play hard and they practice hard and they don't get rattled. So they're very excited.
It's been quite a week. Hopefully you have a good finish to the week.
I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Okay.
So there you have it. You've met the coaches, you've seen the key players, you've seen how they got here. We're ready to play basketball. Stick around, won't you? The 3A championship game coming up next. Benton Central, Evansville Memorial here on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Well, you're back just in time to pick up the starting lineups. Here's our PA announcer for tonight, Scott Gregg, with the Benton Central lineup.
Number 22, Courtney Lester. Number 24, Kinsey Denno. Number 30, Sophie Marquis. Number 32, Danny Reddick. Number 42, Jenna Denno. Number 50, Alyssa Briette. And the starting lineup for the Bison of Benton Central. At guard, a 5'10" sophomore, number 12, Caitlin Tolan. At guard, a 5'7" junior, number 23, Aaron Cobb. At forward, a 5'10" sophomore, number 14, Cassidy Denno. At forward, a 5'11" junior, number 44, Marie Gadabier. And the center, a 6-foot senior, number 40, Hillary Moore. Head coach of the Bison, David Baxter. And now your roster and starting lineup for Evansville Memorial Tigers. Number 10, Rachel Davidson. Number 14, Nikki Bland. Number 20, Ruth Hedrick. Number 22, Maggie Minette. Number 31, Grace Szymanski. Number 34, Jenna Lutz. Number 52, Emily Nesbitt. And the starting lineup for the Tigers of Evansville Memorial, at guard, a 5'6" senior, number 23, Sarah Stone. At guard, a 5'9" junior, number 32, Natalie Cohlmeyer. At forward, a 6'1" senior, number 42, Anna Hackert. At forward, a 6'1" senior, number 54, Mallory Ladd. And the center, a 6'3" senior, number 50, Marie Hackert. Head coach of the Tigers, Bruce Dockery. Good luck,
the
ladies.
Roster and the starting lineup for both the Bison of Benton Central and the Tigers of Evansville Memorial.
Greatly
for Benton Central, their record is 23-1. And the only loss they had all year, Jane, was at McCutcheon. McCutcheon, a 4A team that finished up number 4 in the final poll, and they lost that game by a deuce, 50-48. Very good ball club.
That was a great game, and that was early in the season in a tournament, in almost like a preseason tournament that goes on, and that was a one loss that Benton Central later avenged against McCutcheon, where they beat them at the Wigwam. They had a game where McCutcheon played BC at the Wigwam. And Coach Baxter talked about that win against McCutcheon in the Wigwam. It was kind of one of those points in the season where their team really picked up a lot of confidence and then took off.
Well, the first loss came in the fourth game of the year, and third from the last game of the year was at the Wigwam, and they won that one by 3 after losing the other game by 2. Evansville Memorial, 27-1 likewise. Their only loss to a really good Brownsburg outscored ball club by 10, 51 to 41 back on the 29th of December.
Yeah, Brownsburg's got the tough center inside with Stephanie Mavunga, and that must have been a terrific game as well.
All right, Memorial in the white uniforms. The Northern teams are the visiting teams in the tournament, just the way it was set up, predetermined that way. So Benton Central will be the away team in the tournament, wearing the dark uniforms. Here's a hell ball to begin the tournament game, the 3A championship, and possession error going back over to Benton Central. Now, your ball club was one of the ball clubs that fell, West Lafayette, to this Benton Central team of the tournament.
First game of the tournament, we unfortunately drew them because they were such a quality basketball team, and they have the opportunity to put big runs together. That's what they did against us. Obviously, against Evansville Memorial, a little more skilled team probably in terms of being able to handle that because of their post players, but right away Benton Central turns it over. A little bit of jitters on both sides in the first possession of the game.
And keep an old close watch, if you will. Now they're going to turn it over again. Keep an eye on 54 for Evansville Memorial in the white uniforms. It's Mallory Ladd. She's a 6'1 senior, and she is the young lady who does it all, averaging 22-7 points and 12 rebounds per game. Also leads the club in steals and is third in the ball club in block shots and assists. But right now, it is Benton Central in the green and a traveling violation there. So early on, and I've seen this so many times, yep, Jane, over the years. It takes these ball clubs, they're so hyper to start the game that things that they normally would not do, they do.
Yep, that's exactly what just happened to Hillary Moore as she tried to drive it down the lane, do a little spin move and lost her footing.
Memorial now in the white uniforms, out on the high post, and they'll drop it down inside. Here is Ladd with the turnaround shot. Good box out inside. And the rebound off to Hillary Moore. Moore averages 8.6 rebounds per game. She is one of the three that we mentioned at the outset of the telecast tonight. They have basically three stars on this team.
They do, and Moore's headed to IPFW, so I'm sure she was excited to come up here to the Coliseum and get to play in the place that she's going to play her college basketball.
I was just thinking about that. This is where she will play her college career, so what a great way to start.
Yeah. She's a very good player, and she's key for their defense tonight because of the post presence that Memorial. You already see Memorial's offense. They've gone inside two out of the three possessions. You can tell that's what they want to try to do against this Benton Central team.
Here they go inside the lab. She had the ball deflected, and it's out of bounds. It'll stay in the possession of Evansville Memorial. No score in the game. We're a minute 15 in. It's another look at this last little movement here defensively.
Moore's going to get a block shot. Nice spacing. She comes over from the help side and gives a nice effort there.
As we come back in, Anna Hackert came off of the rebound and walked to the basketball. I've got them done already for, turnovers. Six teams combined, 3-3 according to my numbers here.
A lot of traveling going on, as if Memorial didn't do it. Oh, Benton Central, too, didn't do enough traveling to get here. Let's stop the traveling, everybody. Let's settle down and play some basketball.
Awfully long trip for a couple of these ball clubs. Evansville Memorial had to travel 310 miles to get here for this tournament. Now, the teams came in. In fact, one of the teams came in on Thursday.
Yep.
But Memorial did make the trip, and they're here, and they're young. They can handle this kind of stuff.
Yeah,
still
sure.
No score in this ball game. Ladd outside now at the top of the circle. She's a 6'1 senior now getting inside, got double teamed. And you got a couple of players to take a pick from here as far as the personal foul is concerned. And they will go with Caitlin Denno. That'll be the first on her and the first against the ball club. But a shooting violation. So Mallory Ladd, who's a terrific free throw shooter at 81%, will be at the free throw line.
Ladd is headed to Valpo, a very strong post player with some good moves. As you see her take it strong to the basket there. She handles the ball like a guard, but she's got great size at 6'1". Good instincts, get to the rebound. You average 12 boards a game. That's terrific for any high school player to go along with those 23 points a game.
Well, she's had two terrific years. Last year had a double-double in every game except one a year ago. And this year she's been equally as effective. Couple of minutes gone. It's a 2-0 ball game now. Memorial has the first lead of the game. Benton Central in the dark uniforms in the green, holding the corner, a three-pointer on the way, an air ball tossed up there, and Ladd comes out of there with it. They'll hustle it back up court, get a wide open 10-footer on the right wing and knock it down. Good looking play by Sarah Stone.
Well, Stone is the player from Memorial. This is her third state championship appearance. Now, Jerry, the first two were in soccer where she was the goalie, but she's got that feel for, hey, big stage, time to be a big time player. She just showed it there with that shot she knocked down.
She has still felt the pressure is what you're trying to say.
Absolutely.
Here's a three that was about 4 feet off the mark and off into the hands of Ladd. And they'll bring it back up court in a hurry with Natalie Cohlmeyer, a 5'9 junior. This Memorial ball club's got some, they've got some size.
Yes, they do, Jerry. And right there you see what they're best at. They've basically got three post players. Any one of those kids would play center on most other
yep.
teams. But he puts all three of them on the floor. They're very good passers. They look for each other very well. And you're going to see it right here with one of the Hackert twins catching the basketball and giving it up to Mallory Ladd flying down the lane as she gets fouled again and gets to go back to the free throw line.
And as we come back to live action, she knocks down the first one. She's 3 out of 3. So she has 3 of the 5. Sarah Stone with the field goal has the other. Here's Mallory. Again, we mentioned she's an 81% shooter. And she has 4 of the 6 on the board. And it's a 6-0 ball game right now. Memorial out in front of Benton Central. Benton Central school colors are green and gold, thus the green and gold uniforms. And it's knocked out of bounds and turned over. It's another turnover now by Benton Central. They're really having some trouble just getting the nerves under control right
they
now.
They are. And, you know, you talked about Ladd's leads the team in steals. She won't get credited with a steal there, but she forced that turnover by getting a deflection on the ball, and that's what went off of Deno's hands.
Jumper on the right side, rolled around the rim and came out of there. And here comes Benton Central again. They need something offensively good to happen to them. Keep an eye on Marie Hackett. It's 6'3". He's got a wingspan of about 6'3 also.
And they, you see Caitlin Tolan finally steps up. She's their clutch. Her team needed a basket. She penetrated that zone, got to the middle where the opening was. Now we're going to see Erin Cobb. She's their main defender, pick up her first foul.
Well, that was a rough foul, too. Erin getting her first. So 3 of the Benton Central ball players have each picked up one. Here's a look at it again.
Cobb always guards the point guard, and she just hassles them to the point where, well, you see her go down there. A little bit too much body contact, so they're going to get her with the foul, but she'll continue to pressure and hassle the point guard.
Danny Reddy comes into the lineup now for Benton Central. Here's the long three off the mark, and the rebound off into the hands of Benton Central. They average 54.6 a game. They give up 35.9. And a three, almost an air ball, just barely caught the rim of the far side of the rebound off to Memorial. They're not giving Benton Central any second opportunity. Here's a three by Ladd. It's off the mark. Rebound taken down by Hackert. It's Marie Hackert, 6'3 senior. Sisters on the ball club likewise. And a timeout with 3 minutes, 47 seconds to go in the opening quarter of play. And the score 6-2 in favor of Memorial. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Here's a little bio on the Benton Central Ball Club. They're located in Oxford, Indiana, about 135 miles west of Fort Wayne, some 25 miles northwest of Lafayette. Destin Haas, the principal. Jim Puckett's the AD. They're members of the Hoosier Conference. Enrollment of 594 students. And the school colors, green and gold. Runners-up in 1989, Scottsburg beat them that year, 74-72 in overtime. And one of the legends in coaching, Jan Connor, was in charge of that particular ball club. They were 24-3 this year.
A couple of legends that year, Jan Connor versus Donna Cheatham.
Oh,
so
gosh, yeah.
I actually remember that as a player. I wasn't playing high school anymore, but still very good basketball game. And, Jan's in attendance tonight watching the Bison play, so it's kind of fun to have legends back.
I was at a Franklin College game a couple of weeks ago, and she was there because one of her former players was playing for Franklin College. So she is truly, and I say this in all the respect, she's a gym rat.
Well, she is, absolutely. And, you know, kind of like Bruce Dockery. You think about him, and most people, if they have an appendectomy, they're not getting on the sideline. But, man, it's in his blood. He can't stay anywhere but right there on the sideline.
There's Caitlin Tola, the young lady you said was going to have to carry the load. She scored all 5 of the points now for Benton Central. We're 5 minutes into the game. And it's a 6-5 basketball game, and not anymore, because they got Anna Hackert loose inside for her first couple of points.
Well, there's that high post, low post passing I was talking about. Just, you know, and the amazing thing is, you look at this zone, Jerry, you said 6'3 wingspan. She's playing the top of the zone. She's not even down where the post players normally go. That's how unusual this Evansville team is.
Well, they're a very good ball club. There's no question about that. They average 61.3 per game and give up only 34 points a game. So you better be on your toes defensively. Here's another turnover now by Evansville Memorial. Here comes Benton Central back at the other end. It's out of bounds. The officials trying to make a decision as to which way it'll go, and it will stay in the possession of Benton Central. Back into the ball club, Cassidy Deno now back onto the floor for Red Benton Central.
Good steal by Tolan as she picks it up, but look at all those Evansville Tigers, Memorial Tigers, just chasing her, and it goes off, I believe it was off Marie Hackett's feet.
2.5 to go in the opening quarter of play. Open shot on the side by Reddick. Nothing doing. Comes off into the hands of Mallory Ladd. And Ladd, who is a terrific rebounder at 12 per game, seems to be there all the time.
She's already got three, and we're just in the first quarter with a couple minutes left to go. So expect her to hit that double digit like she always does.
She made the move inside that time, and a nice play by Hillary Moore to put the stop to that.
Well, Moore just kind of hangs out defensively, and she is a very good shot blocker. Controls her body very well, good footwork, and was able to get the tip on Ladd's ball. That's kind of fun to watch those two go at it.
Great defensive play by Hillary Moore.
Again.
And Moore is playing some defense. We've talked about her offense at 12-3 and 8-6 rebounds, but she's playing great defense.
Well, she's got that third block, and the officials are letting her play. The thing about her is she gets that spacing. If you're going to get a foul on her, you got to get your body into her. And you see Anna Hackert try to, but Moore went straight up and down and just tipped it away on top.
Ruth Hedrick, number 20, 5'6 junior. For Evansville Memorial comes into the lineup. Neither ball club shooting well. Benton Central 2 out of 8. Evansville Memorial 2 of 11. 2 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Still a low scoring affair at 8-5 in favor of Evansville Memorial. And it'll be out of bounds, and it'll stay in possession of Evansville. Nice defensive effort down low that time by Reddick, a 5'8 junior.
You know, Reddick and Gatterberg, kind of an interesting story. Gatterberg's a foreign exchange student staying with the Reddick family, and Danny is somebody that comes off the bench. And Gatterberg took the starting position there. She's been a really nice addition for this Benton Central ball club.
Mallory Ladd's first field goal is a 3. Yeah, that is interesting that she comes in as a foreign exchange student from Denmark. However, she was born in Maryland.
Yes.
And we'll talk more about that as they turn the ball over again to Benton Central. That's a half a dozen now. Born in Maryland, lived there for the first 3 years of her life. Dana Reddick's parents are Gatterberg's hosts. And Marie was the Wigwam Classic MVP. A timeout is taken by, it's a 32nd timeout, taken by Benton Central.
Well, she's just gotten better and better with every game because she got more familiar with the system and comfortable with the way Coach Baxter runs things. And I think that she was the missing piece for this Benton Central ball club because they needed another post player to defend and attack the basket, and she's done that very well this season.
Well,
for them.
Here's a look at the Evansville Memorial team factual lineup. Daryl Hagan's the superintendent of the school system down there. Gwen Godsey's the principal. Bruce Dockery is also the AD as well as being the head coach, Southern Indiana Athletic Conference. Royal blue and white are their colors. Enrollment is actually 784. We talked about the fact that they are 310 miles away. Bruce Dockery, by the way, his record, an amazing 387 and 131 in his 24th year at the school.
Well, he's still present, but he will be and is already a legend in girls basketball. The things that Bruce has done for the game has been terrific. He's produced a tremendous amount of great players. He's very involved with the State Basketball Association and just a class act when it comes to coaches.
Boy, Hillary Moore doing a nice job defensively, getting the rebound that time. Here's the move underneath the bucket, and that is in a Marie Gatterberg.
She got the offensive rebound. That's the thing. People pay a lot of attention to Tolan, Deno because of her shooting, and Moore because of her inside play. And Gatterberg's able to pick up just some easy stuff as Hillary Moore gets her fourth block.
That's terrific stuff. That was the first point scored by anyone other than Caitlin Tolan in this ball game for Benton Central. And a foul will be called against Evansville Memorial. The official making his way to the far side. The foul is going to be on Ruth Hedrick, and that'll be number one on Ruth. Our officials for this game, Scott West, Mark Hopper, and Mike Alford. James Robinson is the alternate. Let's hope he's not needed, because if he is, that means one of the other guys has come down with an injury. We don't want that to happen. Final 44 seconds of the opening quarter of play, 3A championship, and Benton Central almost throws it away. Good save over there by Aaron Cobb. Into the lane and back outside to Deno. There are three Denos on this ball club, a couple of sisters and a cousin. Inside they go to Gatterberg, and Gatterberg lost it, but it's picked up by Cassidy Deno. And a held ball, possession arrow, we'll say in possession of Benton Central. It's interesting, when Gatterberg came over here, they literally had to teach her the game of basketball. They brought her in as a student manager.
Yeah.
One day the coach said, Bruce Dockery said, well, David Baxter said, let me see what you got. That was it.
Yep. Well, she's one of those kids that she can drive to the basket. She's a good, strong body. She had to adjust to some of the American rules.
Yep.
Get out of the lane. You get an extended lane in European basketball. And she didn't have a shot clock, which was different. As you see, Mallory Ladd, 3 feet behind the three-point line at the buzzer almost, but she misses. They get the offensive putback for the final score.
Anna Hackert gets the final 2 points of this period, and if we go to the second quarter, it's 13-7. Memorial on top. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Welcome back. Evansville Memorial has the lead over Benton Central after one quarter. I spent a couple of timeouts listening to Bruce Dockery during his timeouts. You would not know he had any kind of medical problems. Full of energy, full of advice. In fact, at one point he said, we're not doing the high-low game. And then right that, the next play, they went high-low. As for Benton Central, in their timeout just before the end of the quarter, Coach Baxter said, we've got to block out. They're killing us on the glass, and it's not Mallory Ladd. So that's a key point of emphasis for Benton Central.
All right, thank you, J.J. Jeremiah Johnson handling activities on the floor. Jerry Baker along with Jane Schott here at the War Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Another turnover this time by Memorial. Neither ball club, Jane, shooting the ball at all well. It is now for Evansville, for Benton. That's 3 of 12, Evansville, 4 out of 16. Rebound advantage to Evansville Memorial, 13-7. Six turnovers for Benton Central, and five for Evansville Memorial. Now with six.
Natalie Cohlmeyer filling the Benton Central pressure right there. It's been all defense right there. You see Hillary Moore with the block, one of her four. Oh, there's another one. She's been terrific down inside. And then there's a third of the four blocks for Hillary Moore, a defensive stalwart so far in this game.
13-7 is your score now with Evansville Memorial out in front.
They're going to get Marie Gatterberg with a moving screen down low. Didn't see what happened, but I can tell by the way the official called the foul, she got a little too much body on that screen.
That's her first personal foul, personal foul. First quarter scoring, Tolan with five, Gatterberg with two for Memorial. They had seven from Mallory Ladd, four from Anna Hackert, and the other two from Sarah Stone. So three of the starters for Benton Central did not score, and two of the starters for Evansville Memorial did not score in that first quarter of play. A minute into the second quarter, another turnover by Memorial. Here comes Benton Central. Nice pass inside. Great looking move to the hoop that time by Hillary Moore. No bucket, but she got the foul, and she'll go to the free throw line.
Well, that's one of the things Benton Central wanted to do, make this a full court game. You got to get it off the glass, which they did. Aaron Cobb pushes it down, and a nice pass inside from Danny Reddick into Hillary Moore to finish that transition. She didn't get the basket, but she gets to go to the free throw line.
First foul of time on Ladd, second against the ball club here in the opening quarter. Front end of the front of the two shots, Hillary Moore missing. She's a 77% free throw shooter.
Well, that, as a team, Jerry, they shoot 72% from the free throw line, which is very good for a high school team.
And Memorial's not far behind. They shoot 70%. Here's the long range three by Ladd. And again, I'm a little surprised at 6'1". She's taken a lot of outside shots in this game.
She's already hit one of them. She's tough to defend if she can score inside and outside. She shoots 40% from behind the arc, so I say shoot it, big girl.
Let it go, huh?
Absolutely.
Memorial appears to be in a zone defense right now. They have sent Erin Cobb right out to the point, and she is guarding her opponent out in that area out there.
Well, that right there is Cassidy Deno, the best three-point threat for the Bison, 43% behind the arc, and she finally found a spot where she could get an open look. That Evansville Memorial 1-2-2 zone has really shut her down so far, but she just got free.
Cassidy Deno with 42 three-point field goals on the year, and Memorial will turn the ball over one more time. I've got him for 8 turnovers now in the game.
Both teams just sloppy. And it's
they
good
are.
Defense. There's no question. It's good defense. I wouldn't call them unforced turnovers, but they definitely are maybe careless turnovers. A lot of them just kind of a little careless, maybe nervous. A lot of things you could say on the offensive end, but fairly good defense as well.
Well, nice bounce pass inside of a good-looking finish by Hillary Moore. Moore, average of 12.3, gets her first 2 points of the contest.
She a little 5-0
run. Just came up the free throw line and missed a couple. Ladd trying to force the issue and draws the foul.
Well, Moore's been able to get block after block after block, and that's going to be her first personal. She's got to stay on the floor for the Bison.
Oh, yeah.
When you look at the three post players for Evansville Memorial, you've got to have that defensive post presence. She reached right there a little too much before Ladd even got into her shooting motion. So Ladd's going to the free throw line.
Ladd hits the first of two, got him both. She is perfect now in 6 tries on the free throw line. 9 points in the ball game for Mallory Ladd. 15-12 is your score with Evansville Memorial hanging tough. They've led by as many as a half a dozen. In fact, they had the first 6 points of the game.
Tigers have gone to a 2-3 zone.
And a traveling violation, another turnover on Benton Central.
Yeah,
they jump into that zone, and it seems to have kind of slowed things down a little bit for the Benton Central offense right now.
She had the right idea, attacking the basket, especially because you saw Marie Hackert come flying out at her to try to stop the shot. She was able to get on the inside of her.
Let Marie Hackert alone, and she misses the outside shot. Now here's the offensive foul that will be called against Anna Hackert.
Well, Marie shoots it. Anna got the weak side board. Good position, good body work there. As she caught it, though, she kind of used a little bit of elbow to clear some space. I think they've, you know, we talked about that earlier today on the Bill Russell quote. You don't have to block every shot. You just got to make them think that you're going to block it. So right now, the Memorial post players even, they've been blocked quite a bit, so they feel a little bit of intimidation perhaps, and she cleared some space.
Nice baseline pass over on the near side, and a block this time coming the other way. Marie Hackert, who leads the club in block shots with 58 coming into this game, gets her, I think, her first of the game. Here is Ladd getting inside and getting in trouble and turning the ball over. They are now in double figures, Evansville Memorial, in turnovers, and we still have, well, we're 4:42 to go in the second quarter. That's way too many turnovers.
Right. We don't have a stat on what they average a game, but I'm sure it's not this many.
Well, they missed a gimme inside from Hillary Moore.
Good high-low pass. Got Moore underneath of that zone defense and got her a nice look.
And again, they bring it up court, they being Evansville Memorial. They don't even try to run a play. They just fire from long range. And as a ball club, they're not bad from 3 points. They shoot 36%. Another turnover for Benton Central. It's 9 now.
Sarah Stone showing her quick soccer goalie hands.
Now here's a foul down of the baseline area away from the ball. Let's see who they put this on.
I think they're going to get Cassidy Deno for a little bit too much of a grab on Anna Hackert. You know, when Benton Central's in this 2-3 zone, you look who they've got across the baseline. Moore's in the middle as a post player. The two on the wings are Danny Reddick and Cassidy Deno, a little bit smaller than the Tigers post players. So Deno trying to get a little bit of an advantage by hanging on and putting a little bit of pressure. She ends up holding too much.
Emily Nesbitt, a 6-foot junior coming in. Marie Hackert, a 6'3 senior going out of the lineup now for Memorial. And they steal the inbounds pass. It's just not been a very pretty game right now, but pretty doesn't count. You're trying to put points on the board. Another air ball fired up from long range by Cassidy Deno, and a held ball. Possession arrow in favor of Evansville Memorial. A timeout. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance of the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Halfway through the second quarter here at the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne. Second year we've been here for the state championships. Field goal percentages are really horrible. Benton Central, 5 of 17, that's 29%. Evansville, 4 of 21, 19%. Turnovers, 10, Evansville, Benton Central with 9. And normally by this time of the game, Jane, the clubs, we talked about them being hyper when they came out. They've settled down by now, but that's not the case. Now, let's give credit to the defense. Right. Maybe that's the cause.
Partly it is, but I'm going to say for the Tigers, they're taking quick shots. Now,
yes.
I haven't watched them play all year. Maybe this is the way they're comfortable playing, but it's one or two passes, jump shot every time. Instead of in the early going, they were getting the ball down inside. This time not. As you see, Aaron Cobb off the miss, taking it strong to the basket. Misses the layup, but still got a good look.
Block shot by Anna Hackert. She is second on the team with block shots with 43. Here's that pull-up quick shot again with no offensive setup at all. The rebound to Emily Nesbitt, who averages 2.3 per game, and another turnover.
Cohlmeyer did. When she got the pass, she kind of gathered herself and pulled that pivot foot just a little bit.
That's 11 turnovers now for Memorial. Ball club, it's 27-1. Here comes Benton Central. Their head coach, David Baxter, a graduate of Covington High and Purdue University. Former coach at Attica, spent 8 years there. Replaced Pat Cole at Benton Central.
Memorial back in their 1-2-2 zone defense. Effective as Benton Central tries to get it to the wing, and there's a guard defending right standing waiting there to grab the pass.
Wide open shot that time missed by Nesbitt, and here comes Benton Central again, the Bison. I tell you, this Memorial defense is all over them right
very
now.
Very active. Sarah Stone, see her right in front of us, just hassling the guards coming down. Great hands, plays extremely hard.
Now what they've done, they've taken Stone off the point right now, moved her over to the side just a little bit. She's still out front, don't misunderstand.
Right.
But what they've done now is move Anna Hackert, who's 6'1", where Stone is 5'6",
well,
and that alone's going to have an impact.
The substitution of Nesbitt coming in, she came in for Marie Hackert, who was playing up high. And when that happened, then they moved Anna Hackert up high, and obviously they think Anna's better at the point spot for whatever reason, and that puts Sarah Stone at the wing. I think that's the one thing. I was talking with the Evansville Memorial managers before the game. They were giving me a little lowdown on the team, and I was asking them about their defense. As you see, Danny Reddick get through the teeth of that defense, got into the gap and made a nice drive to the basket. But they said Coach Dockery learned from last year's semi-state, wanted to have more defenses for this team to be able to change to when things didn't go well for his team, and they've got it so far tonight.
For Reddick, her first 2 points of the game, and now for the first time of the game since the opening tip, Benton Central has a chance to grab the lead. They're down by one at 15-14. The clock showing less than 2 minutes to go here in the opening half of play. It's been a quickly played half, but it's not been a thing you want to put in the time ball.
Well, they've, as we've said, all those turnovers, that stops the clock, Jerry. So
yep.
If you were expecting to get to bed early tonight watching the games, it's not going to happen.
We got nowhere to go anyway.
That's
Jane.
Right. Get a little caffeine, you'll be all right.
Nice looking play inside. Hillary Moore getting her second bucket, the first lead change of the game. And for the first time, Benton Central has come back from 6 down to take a 1-point lead.
Well, it's a 9-2 run for the Bison, and they've been able to do it with a balanced attack.
Shot is off the mark that time by Cohlmeyer. Rebound taken down by Ladd, and she's going to go back to the free throw line again.
The key is going to be, who is that foul on? Right now, second quarter, Evansville has yet to be able to get a field goal to go down. They're 0 for 10. Benton Central is 4 for 10, a little bit closer to their season average.
And again, Mallory Ladd at the line, and she has been perfect from that free throw line. She's 7 for 7 back into the lineup. Marie Hackert coming in for Evansville Memorial. Going out of the ball game is Emily Nesbitt.
Personal fouls for the Bison. Take a check on that. 2 for Denno, 2 for Moore, and 2 for Gatterberg. So that will be something to watch.
We'll keep an eye on that because they can ill afford to lose any of those players. Here's another turnover now by, taken away because Benton Central got it right back. They had lost it momentarily. Inside a minute now, and a block shot and a hammer by Anna Hacker. We mentioned she's second on the team with Block shot with 43, and Benton Central wants a 30-second timeout. 30-second timeout for the Bison as they head to the sideline under head coach David Baxter. Charlie Butler, Bob Feemster, Pat Cole, Carter Morgan are the assistants over there. The ratings this year, they were ranked number 11, they being Benton Central, in the preseason poll by the Indiana Coaches of Girls Sports. At the end of the year, ranked number 3. The IBCA, which ranks them regardless of class, did not rank them at the opening of the season and had them number 10 at the end of the year. Evansville Memorial, on the other hand, ranked number 1 in the state in Class 3A by the coaches, number 11 in the state overall by the IBCA. When things were said and done, they were still number 1 in the coaches' poll and number 5 by the Basketball Coaches Association. So that's an outstanding Evansville Memorial team.
Well, both of them played very well. When Benton Central upset McCutcheon, McCutcheon was in the top 10 in the top 20 for the IBCA, and that's what put them in there. And Evansville Memorial, I think because of Ladd and their post players, everybody expected them to be good all season long.
Well, I followed them all year, kind of keeping an eye on them. You kind of look and see who you might be working with in state finals time. And I've had my eye on this Evansville Memorial Club all year, as well as Benton Central, by the way.
Well, Memorial Tigers come out in a trap now. So they've been playing the 1-2-2. It's been effective. But now what they're doing is they're trapping up top. Look, there's 3 white jerseys around Caitlin Tolan. She can't get a pass off. But fortunately for her, she gets fouled.
By Marie Hackert. That'll be number 1 on her. Nobody in trouble with Evansville Memorial. Here's a look at that good defensive effort.
Right there, you see Sarah Stone, Hackert, and oh, there's the other Hackert. You're getting sandwiched by 6'1", 6'3", and a soccer goalie who's got great hands. That's tough.
Hackert's. Marie hoping to go to a smaller school to study graphic design. Anna wants to pursue athletic training at a bigger school, they say.
Well, that was one of the things the manager said as well. They couldn't be more different.
Yeah.
That was one of the comments because, you know, you always think, oh, twins, are they going to be identical? What's it like? But they said it's easy to tell them apart.
Pull-up shot by Ladd on the way off the mark. They had time to run a play but didn't get it done. Down to 4, down to 3. Half-court shot way off the mark. It'll go out of bounds. And that will take care of things in a wild and woolly, not particularly well-played first half. The Evansville did not score a field goal in the second quarter. They had 4 free throws from Mallory Ladd, and that is it. But they are still up 17-16, which means they scored 4 points in the quarter. Benton Central scored 9. Let's go down to JJ.
Here with David Baxter, and Coach, I heard one of your timeouts. You said stay physical, keep taking it at them, and I think your girls are answering the challenge in the physicality department.
Well, we have to with the size that they have. You know, I don't think we're doing a good job on the defensive boards. I know they at least have 7 or 8 offensive rebounds. We can't have that and hope to stay in this game, but you're right. We had a good second quarter there to get us back within contact of hopefully sticking around and making some noise in the second half.
They're getting to the free throw line, but you hold them without a field goal in the second quarter.
Hey, we really made some adjustments there in that first little break in the game. You know, they didn't hit some shots, so thankfully, you know, we can keep them off the glass. But you're right, they're such a physical team. Ladd is doing a great job of getting to the line. We've got to clean up those defensive boards and try to get some transition baskets. We had some opportunities there, but, you know, we missed some point-blank shots that we've got to put in a game like this.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. We'll talk to you later. Right now, it's halftime, a 1-point lead for Evansville Memorial as the IHSAA state championships continue. Presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Network. Welcome back to the Class 3A state championship game here with Bruce Dockery, Evansville Memorial. And Coach, when you draw up a game or a diagram, a game plan, you never know how a game's going to go. Did you expect 17-16 halftime score?
No, you know, I from my point of view, I don't think either team's shooting the ball extremely well right now. And that's a tribute to both teams' defenses, I think.
What was your message to the girls at halftime?
We got to be more patient on offense. We got to make more than 3 passes before we look to shoot. So that's what we're going to try to do.
All right, best of luck in the second half. Jarrett?
Well, Bruce is pretty much on target as far as the shooting is concerned. It's been miserable on the part of both ball clubs in the first half of this game. Just taking a quick look at some of the numbers in the first half. Benton Central is shooting 32% on 7 of 22. But here comes the stat numbers up on your screen right now. And you see the field goal percentage for Evansville Memorial, 14% on 4 of 27. Now, what makes this really interesting, Jane, is the fact that Mallory Ladd, one of our highlight players, is 1-for-10 from the field. Our other highlight player, Caitlin Tolan for Benton Central, has only taken 5 shots, 2 out of 5. You see, the rebounds are pretty close. The turnovers are way out of what the coaches want to have. The 3 points, they almost equate each other, but it's just been not a particularly beautifully played first half.
Well, uncharacteristic for both these teams. We don't have a stat on field goal percentage for teams across the state, but I bet these two are close to the top because Benton Central shoots 49% as a team.
Yeah,
means 50% of the time they're making shots. And then Evansville Memorial not too far behind at 45. So both of these teams are in uncharted territory. They are not used to shooting the ball so poorly.
Well, we have talked about how they've shot poorly, but let's also look at the other side of the coin and talk to you about defense, because both clubs have played pretty darn good defense. And there's one of the reasons why right there, although this time it turns into a three-point possibility. Marie Hackert will pick up her second personal foul just 15 seconds into the second half. The basket is good by Cassidy Deno, and she will go to the line. Interesting note on Cassidy Deno. The coach, David Baxter, said she's the best free throw shooter I have ever seen at the high school level.
And remember, he coached Brittany Rayburn, Purdue standout, Indiana All-Star, great player, who was also a very good free throw shooter. But Cassidy is a 91% free throw shooter.
And I am so glad she made that after she,
yeah,
I said
right.
that.
That's right. You could have jinxed her. Would have been all you.
Biggest lead of the ball game for Benton Central. Traveling violation on the baseline that time as Natalie Cohlmeyer saw a bit of a hole, tried to go to the baseline and turns it back over. That's 13 turnovers now for Evansville Memorial.
Well, that time Cohlmeyer, she had a good idea in going to the basket, but she stepped backward with her pivot foot before she took off. That's an automatic travel. Tigers just need to settle down and get to that high-low, get back to the inside game, get back to moving the basketball like they were early on when they took that 6-0 lead. Remember, it was Mallory Ladd and everything inside working for the Tigers.
Of the 8 teams that are here at Fort Wayne today, Evansville Memorial and Brownstown Central are the 2 top offensive clubs, both average 61.3. Great backdoor cut, but lost away on another turnover, this time by Benton Central, so they're likewise the 13 for the game.
Well, you talk about that wingspan of Marie Hackert. You're right, Jerry, it looked open. And as it did look open to the Benton Central player, as Sarah Stone knocks down a big jump shot, there's that clutch. I've been in the state finals. I know how to get this team going. Shot from her, but Maria Hackert, just when you think the lane's open, she sticks that long arm of the law out there and gets a deflection.
Believe it or not, the first time this game has been tied. Well, I guess it's not too unusual with a low-scoring affair. Tied at 19 right now. Benton Central had a 2-point lead a couple of moments ago. They'll try to get back in front and will not get the roll. The rebound taken off by Mallory Ladd. Open and a block at the other end by Hillary Moore. Checking the rebounds in the first half, Mallory Ladd had 7 for Evansville Memorial, as did Anna Hackert. Top rebounder for Benton Central was Hillary Moore with a half a dozen to go with her 4 points. Top score for Benton Central, 5 out of Caitlin Tolan. Top score for Evansville Memorial, Mallory Ladd with 11. Here's a breakaway, and the layup is good.
Another Tiger turnover. They basically just passed it right to Caitlin Tolan, who had an easy lay-in on the other end.
Tolan now with 7 points, her first in the second half. Inside they go to Anna Hackert. Hackert double, triple teamed, but somehow Memorial manages to get out of the jam. They will fire from long range, come up short. Rebound in the middle by Marie Hackert, and she is fouled from behind by Hillary Moore, and that is 3.
Moore had to make the foul or give up the easy layup. I'm sure David Baxter would say, Hillary, just let her have the layup, because now she's going to have to play very cautious for quite a while with 6 minutes left to play in the third quarter. She turns to her coach and says, I got it. Don't take me out, because that's the first reaction a coach has. Get her out of there before she picks up her 4th. She's a senior. She's been not to the state finals before, but she was the only member of the team that made it to the semi-state a couple years ago when they had a very, very good Benton Central team as well. She was a sophomore on that team, so she's been in some postseason play with some big games.
This is the front end of the 2 shots, gets the second. Those are her first, that is her first point of the game. She averages 4.2, so she's not in there necessarily for her offense, but with that height, that's got to be a major factor. So it's 21-20 now with Benton Central up by one. They've led by two. We've had three lead changes, one tie at 19. And now Benton Central in the dark uniforms. Again, the northern schools in the tournament are listed as the visiting team. Thus the reason for Evansville Memorial in the white.
You see the Tigers in that zone. Looks like a man-to-man at times because it's a matchup zone. They don't just stand in their spot and dare you to shoot. They move wherever you are and play you man-to-man in that spot. And pretty active hands. You see the trap down on the baseline right there. Marie Gatterberg gets tied up. Hillary Moore tries to help, but it's too late.
Possession arrow gives the ball back to Memorial. Evansville White's Memorial with it. They drop it inside to Anna Hackert. Comes right back outside on a fire away. And Mallory Ladd with her second field goal, and they have both been three-pointers.
Now, we talked about them settling for the outside jump shot, Jerry, but that's different. It went inside first. The defense sucked down. They're in the zone. Mallory Ladd able to get the post pass back outside and have a wide-open three. She is a great threat.
And she knocks the ball away. It's out of bounds. It'll stay in the possession of Benton Central. Mallory Ladd now with 2 3-pointers gives her 45 on the year.
Boy, tough to defend a kid that can score in the post, that can pass, that can dribble, and hit the three. Valpo's got a gem coming.
4 minutes, 40 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Class 3A championship from the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Jerry Baker, Jane Schott, Jeremiah Johnson on hand to cover it for you. The rest of our IHSAA Champions Television Network crew. Delighted to have you along tonight. Inside, and look out. That may be a foul on Marie. And if it is, that'll be three on her. And that is going to be instead on Mallory Ladd. And it's the second on Mallory.
Well, that time, Vince Sender did a little bit better job of attacking that zone. Where's the gaps? Right there in the middle, because the Tiger defense is coming out strong on the wings. So Marie Gatterberg was stationed at the free throw line. They were able to find her. Once you get to that point, then you look down low, and that's where she found Hillary Moore on the baseline. And Hillary did a nice job of making a strong move to that baseline spot, going up for a shot.
Cobb coming in, ready going out. Moore hits both free throws. So she's 2 out of 4 from the line, has a half a dozen points to go along with a half a dozen rebounds in this game. And it's tied again at 23. Second time it has been tied, and another turnover by Memorial. Well, that's 15 now for Evansville Memorial.
Natalie Cohlmeyer has just really struggled. That's her fourth turnover, and she is their point guard. I think she's felt the pressure not only from Aaron Cobb, who's really checked her a lot on the man-to-man defense, but just in general.
Three-point field goal, no good. Long rebound comes off into the hands of Anna Hackert, who averages 6.3 per game. No numbers on the break, but Ladd will take it up and get the bucket anyway.
Well, when you got a scorer like Mallory Ladd, you ease up on that a little bit. You give her a little more latitude of taking the ball to the basket, even if there aren't numbers.
Well, that's only the third field goal they've had since the first quarter. Remember now, they were shut out, they being Memorial, field goal-wise in the second quarter. Mallory Ladd was 11 points at halftime, has added 5 more. She had 16 in the game. Long range three off the mark, and a bump in the middle as Ladd comes off of the rebound. We'll get a timeout with 3:26 to go now here in the third quarter of play. Score 23-25 with Memorial in front by a deuce. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Welcome back, Evansville Memorial with a 25-23 lead over Benton Central. We've talked about the defensive performance by Hillary Moore of Benton Central, already with 6 blocks in the game. She is now 2 shy of a Class 3A state championship game record. That was 8 set by Tashia Phillips, former Rebuff star. We saw a couple of state individual records broken in the Class 2A championship game for both steals and for rebounds, so maybe we'll see a block record as well, although she needs to stay out of foul trouble, does Hillary.
Thank you, JJ. 3:26 to go now. Third quarter of play, Class 3A championship here in Fort Wayne, and it has been not a thing of beauty, but been fun to watch. 25-23 in favor of Evansville Memorial. Here is the steal, the driving layup, and it is good by Cobb for her first 2 points of the game.
Well, that's what she does best for Benton Central. She's a state performer in the long jump, extremely athletic, and they just forced another Tiger turnover. Bruce Dockery's going to get a little 30 and settle his team down.
Interesting. We're only, well, just over halfway through the quarter, and Bruce has seen all he wants to see. Here is the layup that's coming. We talked about the head coach of Benton Central, David Baxter. Bruce Dockery, after the 4A meeting, we talked about this on Monday, after the meeting of all the coaches, they drove up here. He got back home and had an appendicitis attack less than 24 hours after his 5 p.m. surgery on Tuesday. He was back in school to greet his team for its scheduled practice late Wednesday afternoon. I understand that his wife is kind of medically associated, if you will. She recognized the severity of the situation and got him in. And there was some question whether he was going to be here. My wife, who works for some medical people, said, I'll guarantee you he will be there.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
Here he is.
Well, you know, even if they had to strap him to a chair and make him sit down, I bet he'd still come.
Absolutely.
But you look over on the sideline, both these coaches, class guys, really working hard for their teams, and you wouldn't even have known anything happened to Bruce earlier in the week.
No, if we hadn't brought it up, he wouldn't have brought it up, and nobody would have known about it.
Well, when I went over to talk to their people, that's what they said to me. They were like, what happened to Coach Dockery? What are you talking about? Trying to act like, hey, nothing happened here. We're ready to play ball. So that was fun.
His shot inside by Cassidy Deno. And the score now at 25-all. Third time we've had a tie in this game. Here's the long-range three that's nothing but net. That'll untie things in a hurry with the shot by Sarah Stone.
Well, she's their clutch, and that is what they said about her. Not only is she clutch as a soccer player, but she's their clutch person as they're on their basketball team. Not necessarily their best basketball player, but when they need a basket, she's always the one that comes through. She just showed it again.
And that was only her fifth three-point field goal of the entire year, but what a good time to get it. 2 minutes to go now, third quarter. 28-25 basketball game with Memorial back in front by three after they led by as many as six. They've been down by a couple of points and a foul. And they are looking closely at Anna Hackert. We'll see where they go with the personal foul. And that is who will get it. So Anna has two now. She has two. Marie Hackert, her sister, with two. And Mallory Ladd likewise with two.
Well, Erin Cobb has really improved her offensive game. She's a junior. She was a defender for them since the time she came on the scene as a sophomore, but now she's actually stepped up her offensive game. This is one area where she still struggles. She's only a 50% free throw shooter, but you saw her there on the drive get a good look at the basket.
Nesbitt coming back in. Timeout taken by Benton Central as Cobb misses the front end. And we'll take a break. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. We are back now with the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Jerry Baker alongside Jane Schott, Jeremiah Johnson patrolling the sidelines. Jane, this is one of those games going to be low scoring, a lot of mistakes, but it's going to go right down to the wire.
Very hard fought battle. Both these teams offensive, very good offensive teams, but they've struggled from the field here, so it has been low scoring.
The field goal shooting a little better in the second half of the first half. Memorial shot 4 of 27. The second half, they're 4 out of 7. Benton Central in the first half, as the second free throw is up and good, with 7 of 22. In the second half, they are 3 out of 7, so things have gotten a little bit better.
Neither team can pull away from the other so far. Little mini runs, a little 5-0 here, 6-2 there, but nothing big, so both squads staying close.
Memorial up by a couple of points at 28-26, and they'll turn the ball over again.
Remember one of the keys, Evansville Memorial needed to handle the Benton Central pressure. BC didn't bring this half-court trap until just now in the third quarter. Right now, the Tigers have not been able to solve it yet.
And we've had a record tied already, Jane, for block shots in the game. The next block shot will set a record for all classes.
For 3A, they had 10 in the Brebeuf game versus Wallace C. So we'll see if we get another one to break that record.
All right, Gatterberg getting her first field goal here in the second half. Marie now with 4 points. Levitt at 15. The turnaround shot go good. Nice balking out in the middle that time with the rebound coming off to Benton Central. They've got a chance now to regain the lead. It's tied at 28. We've had four lead changes so far in the game. And we were with us at the outset of the contest. Memorial ran off to a 6-0 start. And look for all the world to be off to the races. All of a sudden, Benton Central came storming back. They never got the lead in the first half, but nonetheless, they got it right down to where they were still in contention. That may have been a block shot
that
right
was
there.
I think by Anna Hackert.
And a foul on Benton Central. We'll see if they gave the block shot at the other end. If they did, that's a new record. The foul is going to be on Caitlin Tolan. That's the first on her.
Well, the block right there and the turnover. Sarah Stone picks it up, goes hard to the glass, and Caitlin Tolan, and just trying to affect her layup, got a little bit too much body, and Stone's going to go to the free throw line. She already made one.
That was on the official score box as a block shot, so we've got a new record there.
Well, in 2007, that's just for 3A, a record for 3A, Brebeuf versus Wallasee. The funny part about that record, Jerry, is there's 10 total combined block shots for the teams. Well, 10 of them were Brebeuf's. 8 of those are Tashia Phillips. You might remember
she was
quite a player, went to Xavier, and has had a terrific college career. And then Wallasee didn't have any, but it set a record for combined team blocks.
What is the, as you've got this out, what's the record for all four classes then, as far as block shots are concerned?
15.
15?
South Bend, Washington, Columbus East for the 4A, but there was two single-A games where there was 15 blocks.
That's
Triton
amazing.
Versus Rising Sun in 2000, and Wood Memorial versus Oregon Davis in 2007. I remember that Wood Memorial team had a 6-3 shot blocker, and they had 10 block shots for their team.
So we have set the 3A record. Now we're looking for the overall record. And it's thrown away, and that's the end of the quarter. We've gone through three. It is 29, Memorial, 28, Benton Central. Final 8 minutes coming up. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Welcome back to a fantastic Class 3A state championship game. Evansville Memorial 29-28 over Benton Central. Someone watching this knows something about winning state championships. Jan Connor won a couple at Martinsville, but also coached Benton Central to a state championship game appearance.
Yeah, we didn't make it. We want these girls to make it. This is the best defense I've seen a high school girls team ever play. That's what Benton Central's known for.
A lot of pride for you when you're watching this and the community support. Does it take you back to when you made your run with Benton Central?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Look at this crowd. We sell more tickets than anybody in the state in Benton County.
Some pride from Benton County. You said you were the second graduating class at Benton Central.
19-something, yeah.
What do you think about the fourth quarter?
We're going to do this. Defense is going to win out.
All right, there you have it, Jerry.
What we need is a little more enthusiasm out of Jen. And we talked about it earlier. She is really one of those great girls basketball aficionados. Fourth quarter is underway. We're 30 seconds in. No score has changed. It is still as it was, 29-28. Then Jan's talking about defense. He's pretty much straight on, Jane. That's pretty much what's happened out there right now.
No question. Both teams shot the ball a little bit better, though, in that third quarter. Benton Central going 4-for-9. And Evansville Memorial also going 4-for-9. So that's a little better than what they did in the first half. And we saw a little better offensive display. Both teams settling down, didn't turn it over quite as much. But the defensive intensity has stayed true on both ends of the floor.
At the free throw line is Hillary Moore. That foul, by the way, was on Emily Nesbitt, her first of the game. So Moore now with 7 points so far in the contest. Her average is 12.3. Looks good on both of them. 8 points now. She is the leading scorer for Benton Central. 7 out of Caitlin Tolan, 6 out of Cassidy Deno, and 4 out of Marie Gatterberg. And a whistle and a foul out high.
You gotta ask what's gonna come first, the foul or the travel. That trap, that is the one place Coach Dockery does not want his team to bring the ball right over the half court and get trapped right there. Mallory Ladd gets trapped. She tries to pass out of it. They're gonna call the foul before she slid her feet on Cassidy Deno.
That's the third foul on her, the fourth against the ball club here in the second half. 30-29, Benton Central.
BC went to the 2-3 zone, and that has served them well because Memorial hasn't been able to get into their high-low post action very well. And with the Tigers not shooting the ball well, they haven't been able to break this zone down.
Well, they have brought Marie Hackert way out high. We got a held ball. Nope, gonna get a foul. Well, it's going to be on Sarah Stone. That'll be the first on the 5'6 senior.
Well, Stone lost the ball up top on the dribble. A little bit too much dribbling against a zone. If you're going to dribble a zone, you better be taking it to the basket. And she wasn't. She's going east and west. You can see her right there. She bobbles it. Caitlin Tolan, little shark in the, you know, senses the blood in the water and dives after the ball. And Stone, in trying to recover, ends up fouling her.
That's the 15 foul, by the way. Benton Central with the basketball now against Fort Wayne Concordia in the semi-state. They started 11-0 in that game, and then Tolan had to make four free throws in the final 37 seconds. So they've been in battles throughout this tournament.
Well, she is a clutch performer, and that's who they want on the free throw line down low. Now, Mallory Ladd's going to get a warning. The whole team gets a warning. She came over the line on the inbounds. She's got the look on her face like, no, I didn't. But official called it, so she's got to takes a step back and doesn't put as much pressure on the inbounder.
90 seconds into the fourth and final quarter. Class 3A championship, 30-29. Benton Central with the lead. Shot outside is short, but a good rebound in the middle by Cassidy Deno. And we'll get a foul on Evansville Memorial.
Great rebound by Deno. Goes up high. It was just out of the outstretched hands of all the bigs down low for the Tigers. You got 6-1, 6-1, 6-3, and Deno, she's 5'10 herself, comes up with that rebound and goes strong to the basket. Anna Hackert arguing that she's straight up and down, and she was, but there was a moment where she took her hands and she pushed down with her hands right on Deno. The moment she broke that plane of verticality is when they called the foul. And so that gives Deno a chance. You don't want to foul that kid going to the free throw line.
Absolutely not. Cassidy, a 91% shooter, as Jane mentioned earlier. She is now 2 out of 2 from the line tonight. Going out of the lineup for Memorial is Marie Hackert.
She kind of has that no-nonsense approach to free throw shooting. I read something in an article where she said, it's a free shot. You should never miss. I mean, that's great. Free throw shooters feel that way. If they miss one, they're ticked off, you know, because they think they should make every one.
It's a great attitude to have.
Absolutely.
They are free. And she is 3 out of 3 on the night. And she has 8 points. And we're going to get a quick foul on the inbounds pass. And the foul will go up against Caitlin Tolan. She's not in any danger. That's only her second personal foul. Memorial is a ball club known for runs against Edgewood in the regional championship. They were hit 26-8, and then Edgewood went on a 23-0 run. So that's the negative side of that. Against Evansville, Harrison back on the 15th of January, they finished the first quarter with a 27-0 run. Here's a wide-open look in the middle of the time as nobody blocked out. And Ruth Hedrick gets her first 2 points of the game.
Well, they finally broke that press effectively. They got it down the sideline and attacked the baseline. And there wasn't a drop defensively on the weak side, so that's why Hedrick was wide open.
5:55 to go now in this ball game. There's your score on the screen, 32-31. Another lead change in this favor of, right now, Benton Central. Now we're going to go back there. Well, they'll add to it.
Hillary Moore on the offensive glass there on the weak side. A good drive by Caitlin Tolan, but defense caused her to miss the shot, and she's going to get almost a steal. Great effort by Tolan as she tips the ball away from Cohlmeyer, but just can't gather it in as it goes out of bounds.
Hillary Moore now in double figures with 10. Moore now very close to a double-double. She has 10 points and 9 rebounds, and a 30-second timeout taken by Evansville Memorial. This is a danger zone. 5.5 minutes to go. They're down by 3. That's their biggest deficit, and I think that Bruce Dockery recognized this is very, very treacherous territory they're in.
More than the score, Jerry, do you feel Big Mo momentum?
Yeah.
Big Mo sitting on Benton Central's bench right now. And you know, when the opposing coach feels that, you got to call a timeout and get your group rallied, because if the momentum shifts to that side at this point in the ballgame, it's tough to regain it.
Bruce Dockery, number 9 in the state among active coaches with victories. I mentioned earlier, 387. He was the 2001 Girls Indiana All-Star Coach. He's a graduate of Evansville Bossy High, University of Southern Indiana. Monica Auker, Whitney Jenkins, Tom Endress, and Joan Miller are his assistants. In fact, Monica was kind of set to run practice when Bruce was semi-laid up.
Well, they go back to that same corner, Jerry, but they got it out that time. Ruth Hedrick able to get it out. They turn it over anyway on a Mallory Ladd drive to the basket.
That's 20 turnovers in this ballgame now for Evansville Memorial. What they did was, as soon as she came across the timeline, Jane, they just trapped her right here. Now you've got the timeline as a defender, and the out about the sideline as a defender. numbers on the break. Let's see what they got here for Sarah Stone.
Boy, Tigers are just cold shooting all night long. A great steal by Mallory Ladd. She pushes it ahead to Stone, and they should have had a maybe a transition turnover layup, but couldn't get it done.
Now a foul out high, completely away from the real action underneath, and the foul is going to be against Memorial. Going to be on Hedrick, number 20, and on Ruth. That'll be number two. It's going to put him in the bonus for checking the shooting over here. Memorial is now 9 of 38 for 23.7%. Benton Central 12 of 34 for 35.3%. And Jane, you talked about how both these ball clubs shoot right around 45%. In fact, Central's up to around almost 50%.
Well, great shot selection has been a mainstay for both squads. They're well coached. They have good players. Coach Dockery talked about his halftime speech was, we're taking too many quick shots, and that's resulted in bad field goal percentage. They seem to have settled down and did a little bit better here in the second half, but now this Benton Central half-court trap has really thrown off the Memorial Tigers' offensive flow, and they haven't really got a good look at the basket very often, even in the second half.
That was the seventh foul against Memorial, so we're in the one-and-one portion of the bonus. Tolan, who's a 73% shooter, that was her first free throw attempt of the game. And Central gets them both their biggest lead of the game. Up by five, 36-31. Benton Central with a record of 23-1. Wide open underneath, and they got the ball inside to Anna Hackert for her first point since the first quarter of this game.
Memorial Tigers finally solved that puzzle. Now they got to continue to do that if they want Benton Central to get out of that trapping zone.
They're going to get a foul called against Natalie Cohlmeyer. That'll be the first on the 5'9 junior. Cohlmeyer, who averages 11-2, Jane has yet to score this game.
She's had a tough day. 0-for-6 from the field, 6 turnovers. The pressure from Aaron Cobb when BC was in the man-to-man, I think, really kind of set her back a little bit. And she's just never really found her rhythm on the offensive end.
Again, the one in bonus, and it rattles in for Cassidy. I mentioned earlier, the coach said, best free throw shooter he's ever coached.
Well, Evansville Memorial has sent Deno to the line. This will be the 6th free throw attempt for her in this quarter. Only one field goal for the Bison so far in this quarter, but they've been able to go on a 10-4 run. 8 of those points from the free throw line.
Hillary Moore coming back onto the floor, replacing Marie Gatterberg. Gatterberg going out of the lineup with 4 points. Hillary Moore coming in with 10.
Moore's had a nice basketball game. She must have heard us talking all about the Memorial post players, and she said, hey, wait a minute, I'm a great post player too.
Well, once again, they hit the outside shot. Ladd misses it now, but gets the offensive rebound off the feed that time from Anna Hackert. And Ladd now with her first contributions point-wise here in this fourth quarter. Mallory now at 18 points of the game. We're halfway through period number 4.
Well, she has 8 rebounds to go. She's nearing her double-double effort.
And there was a semi-block. Ladd changed the direction of that shot. I'm not sure she'll get credit for a block or not, but she sure changed things.
I think she got it because it went right back in Moore's hands. And if it's not a block shot, then that would have either been a jump ball or a travel by. And they didn't call either of those, so I would expect them to credit her with a block shot.
Well, they got Marie Hackert, 6'3", playing out of the wing at the upper portion of your screen. Here's a traveling violation. We'll take a timeout. The clock showing 3.5 minutes to go, and you're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Crowd beginning to grow here at the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum. Jerry Baker, Jane Schott, J.J. Jeremiah Johnson on duty. Happy to be with you. Here is the defensive play by Ladd. Well, she got a good hand on that basketball.
They credited her with one, but that's a block shot. And very good job by Hillary Moore to stay with it. But we've seen some terrific post defense tonight without fouling. Moore, Ladd, Hackert, and Hackert have combined for 11 block shots for both teams, and it's been tough interior defense.
Now let's see what might be on the mind of David Baxter, the head coach of Benton Central, because he can slow things down if he so desires right now, Jane, because they've got themselves a three-point lead. Do you change anything with 3.5 to go?
Well, I think that right now they're going to work some clock. They've already done one thing. They've pulled Memorial out of that zone, and they went man-to-man. Mallory Ladd's going to get a steal.
Ladd right at the front of the free throw line, gets the roll. Mallory Ladd with 20 points now in this game. Her average is 22-7, and she is the kind of player that can single-handedly take over a basketball game. She's got her ball club to within one with 2:50 to play. Offensive foul. It'll be on Tolan.
Caitlin Tolan taking it strong to the basket. And that's one of those where not a lot of contact, but when you watch the replay, watch the off arm of Caitlin Tolan. She may extend it just a little bit, not enough to knock Hackert down. Let's be honest. However, that's part of the game.
Absolutely.
Hackert stepped in and took the Hollywood charge, and it gets called.
So 38-37, BC on top. They've got a chance this Memorial to regain the lead. We've had unofficially a half a dozen lead changes in this game. Here's another turnover. And again, it's that chipping of the feet. And that's 23 turnovers now for Evansville Memorial. Give it right back to Benton Central.
Yep, on Natalie on the catch, doesn't get her feet set for a shot. And then when she does that, she's just a little happy on down low.
2.5 to go. Fourth quarter, Class 3A championship game on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. They dropped it inside, and oh my goodness, they had Gatterberg wide open. They go back out long range instead, and the rebound taken off by Anna Hackert. Hackert happened to be playing. She thought she tore her meniscus late in the loss to Brownsburg in the Hall of Fame Classic. Turned out the MRI exam was negative, given medical clearance to play. So Memorial with it. And now with a minute 55 to play, they trail by one. And we'll have a foul, and again, three green jerseys.
That's
so
right,
the officials will make a choice, and they'll put the foul on Cobb. That'll be two on her.
Mallory Ladd gets the chance to add to her point total. She's 8 for 8 from the free throw line so far tonight.
Bonus in effect.
20 points to go along with 9 rebounds so far, 5 steals, and I think she's got a block or two.
Perfect on the free throw attempt. Now the bonus coming up. Tie ball game at the moment at 38. Ladd going to Valpo, had a double-double. As I mentioned, in all the games but one a year ago, she gets both free throws. Past the 1,000 career points her junior year. She averaged 22 points and 14 boards last year.
First lead Memorial's taken here in the fourth quarter. They led 29-28 going into the fourth. But remember, BC scored right away, and they've led the entire way until this last 1:30 where Ladd's free throw now puts Memorial up.
At a timeout will be taken as they get wiped out in front of the Evansville Memorial bench. Anna Hackert doing a good defensive job, got the ball back, and we'll take a break. You're watching tonight the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Welcome back. What a difference a couple of minutes can make. I listened in to Bruce Dockery in the huddle a couple of minutes ago. Evansville Memorial trailed by three, but he said, we're in good shape. Crash the boards and run your high-low quickly. Evansville Memorial forced a turnover. They since have 4 quick points. Now they have the basketball in the lead. So a quick turn of events will be interesting to watch this final minute 26, Jerry.
Half a dozen lead changes, JJ, and a half a dozen ties in this ball game. Right now, Memorial with the lead. And a minute 26 to play, and they are up 39-38.
Well, it's been all Mallory Ladd for Memorial. They're on a 6-0 run. It's a 6-0 run for Ladd. She has been their offense in the last few possessions.
They put Hillary Moore on Ladd. Inside, shot off the mark. Rebound taken out by Hillary Moore. Leading rebounder for Benton Central with 8.6 a game. Clock showing down 1 minute exactly to play in this Class 3A championship game. Now let's see what Benton Central wants to do. They're down by one. They'll take the outside shot, and they will hit it. Great shot by Cassidy Deno.
Credit Hillary Moore for a great flare screen for Deno to free her up.
And the lead goes back over to Benton Central. They'll try to tie it. They do. They get it. Anna Hackert, second field goal this quarter, 8 points of the game, and we're tied at 41.
We knew this game would come down the wire.
We said this earlier. We're going to get a timeout taken by Benton Central. We said no matter how ragged the play may be, we're going to see a game that's going right down to the final seconds. You are watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. They're just doing some quick checking on the schedules here. Only one of these two ball clubs, Evansville Memorial, has played overtime this year. Memorial beat Plainfield at Plainfield back on the 7th of December, 68-66. Ladd had 40 points and 18 rebounds in that game.
She's been terrific. She's got, you see the Deno 3 right there. Then they go down inside. Gatterberg goes down, and so Hackert has an open jump shot to tie it up.
Now, what are we going to do? We're going to play for the final shot?
Yeah, I think they're going to look for the best shot that they can get within 10 seconds. You got to be careful not to get trapped up there. Long arms up there trying to pass out of that corner.
Well, they're playing right in the hands of Memorial. They almost had the violation called, and very quickly Benton Central, I think, is going to take a timeout. That's a good call on the part of the head coach, David Baxter, because they were jammed. A break. Coming back in a minute with the final 9.1. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals. It's presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Welcome back. A tie game, 9.1 seconds left. Benton Central ball. I listened to both of David Baxter's most recent timeouts. Two ago, he said, attack the basket if you can. Now he's like 9.1, go to the basket. Doesn't want any turnovers. He said, no timeouts left. He reminded his girls that.
We're watching the officials, Scott West, Mark Hopper, and Mike Alford. They got together and huddled out there. And what they were saying was, hey, guys, get your game face on. Final seconds, 6 seconds, 5, 4, 3. A wild shot, no good. We're going to go overtime, I believe. Yes, we are. So we'll go to overtime with a score tied at 41. Benton Central, Evansville Memorial. And you are watching it all in the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Third game of the day. Earlier today in the Class A Championship, Vincennes Rebay, a 49-40 winner over Turkey Run. Shelby Davies of Turkey Run, the Medal Attitude Award winner. Class 2A, it was Fort Wayne Lures 59, Brownstown Central 46, Samantha Bain of Brownstown Central won the Patricia Elroy Medal Attitude Award. And now, James Schott, we're going OT.
Well, this kind of game actually favors Benton Central if you look at the overall season, only because BC has won many games in the 40s this year. They've had 7 wins when it's in the 40s. Evansville Memorial's only been there, not even in the 40s, once. They won one game 21-9. You mentioned that top of the broadcast. Every other game has been 50 or above, so Memorial definitely not having the offensive output they're used to.
We talked early on in the telecast about how both these ball clubs keep the opposition scoring low, 35-9 for Benton Central and 34-3 for Evansville Memorial. So while we have talked about how shambled this game may be, the defense has been the cause of
it
all
has.
Of that.
It's been good defense on both sides, and right there you saw an offensive rebounding effort by Anna and Marie Hackert. Both of them going hard, and they find Sarah Stone for the 3 on the right side.
And that's the biggest lead that Memorial's had in a long, long time. They're up by 3 now, and Stone gets her 11th point of the game. At the other end, they try to answer, can't get it done. The rebound to Marie Hackert. Hackert with 3.5 rebounds per game. Now they've got, they did have momentarily numbers on the break. They'll drop it inside, and here's a hammer foul coming in outside by Hillary Moore, and that should be 4 if it goes on Hillary. We'll hold off for a second and see. That is her. That's her 4.
Well, they did have numbers, and they chose to attack. A nice high-low pass from Mallory Ladd down to Cohlmeyer, and they're going to get Moore for the 4th foul.
Cohlmeyer still has not scored in this game.
Natalie Cohlmeyer had 15 points in their game last week in the semi-state, so she's used to scoring a few points. She averages 11.2 a game, 74% free throw shooter. Ladd had 33 last time out.
Cohlmeyer 0-for-6 from the field. Two beautiful free throws. Now all of a sudden, It is a 5-point ball game at 46-41. Keep in mind that Memorial's biggest lead was 6-0 at the south outset of the game tonight.
Well, now Memorial's bringing that trapping half-court zone, and BC knows how to break it because they play it all the time. So they got a good look inside, but they couldn't get the layup to go down.
Cassidy Deno on the miss. The rebound comes off into the hands of Marie Hackert. Here they come now. Evansville on a 15-5 run.
Now, remember, they were down 5 when Bruce Dockery called that timeout, 36-31.
And we'll get a reach-in foul this time on Cassidy Deno. That'll be 4 on her. She joins Hillary Moore with 4 personal fouls.
Well, there's a lot of time left, Jerry. Oh, yeah. Right now, Benton Central doesn't need to panic, but what they do need is they need to come up with some offense on the other end. You can't keep having empty possessions, because right now the Evansville offense has found its rhythm.
Well, whatever the coach, Bruce Dockery, told him during that timeout you referred to, he might want to write that down and use that for future reference.
Well, I'll tell you what I think. You know, we talked about Big Mo sitting on BC's bench a little while ago. It shifted. Mallory Ladd took over, and it went to Evansville Memorial. When they got the stop, defensive stop to send it into overtime, I felt like they had a lot of energy running to the bench.
Ladd now with 22, and Ladd comes out with the loose ball. Quickly up court they come to Sarah Stone, driving to the hoop, misses the shot. The putback is up and good, though, by Anna Hackert. And Hackert now with 10 points. She's in double figures, and just like that, Evansville Memorial has its biggest lead of the game, 48-41, as we take a break and come back to the final, 2:13, here on the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance IHSAA Champions Television Network. Back in Fort Wayne, here's a bit of a game recap for you. At the end of the first quarter, Memorial led Benton Central 13-7 at halftime, with Evansville Memorial not getting a field goal in the second quarter. They were still up 1, 17-16. Through 3, still tight, 29-28 in favor of Memorial. At the end of the fourth quarter, tied at 41, we're in overtime with 2:13 to go. And right now, Memorial with its biggest lead of the entire game at 7.
Well, that clutch performer, Sarah Stone, stepped up and hit a 3 right out of the overtime beginning of that. And I think that just really settled her team into, we're fine, let's go make this happen.
Now you get a blocking foul, going to be called against Evansville. And the foul is going to be on Anna Hackert. That'll be the 4th one on her.
Anytime you go cold from the field, get something going to the basket. That's what Caitlin Tolan does. Anna Hackert just a little bit late, and also didn't have a great angle. And Tolan did a nice job avoiding the charge. She, right now, Benton Central in the last 7 minutes has gone 1-for-8 from the field. They went cold. On the other hand, Evansville, 7-for-13. Part of that is, Jerry, they've been getting layups. Once they solved that press, that zone press, they were able to get some nice, easy looks at the basket.
Changed everything.
Yep.
Tolan, only a sophomore, averaging 13 per game. She now has 11. And 12. Check it, make it 11 altogether. It's 7-9 going into the overtime, so 11 points in the ball game now for Caitlin. And a wide open look underneath for Mallory Ladd.
Again, the defense is breaking down for BC. Yep. They really were able to put the pressure on early. Now they're overplaying, probably because they're behind. They're trying to trap, and then you give up a layup if you don't get the steal.
Well, old lady momentum went completely to the other end of the court. There's no question about that. Benton Central at one time looked like a team that was really on its way to the championship. They were doing everything right. All of a sudden, things kind of turned around. Sarah Stone coming up the right side. She had a wingman on the far side, Marie Hackert, with nothing to do for her. So they just bring it back out and set the offense up. Here's a bumping foul. This will be on Tolan. That'll be 4 on her. So she joins Cassidy Deno and Hillary Moore with 4 personal fouls.
Well, they're trying to play the clock and get a quick foul, but now they've got problems because Tolan's got 4, Moore's got 4. Both of those players on the floor can't be the people that are going to foul, or they're out of the game. You really need them for offensive punch on the other end.
Memorial, over the last 5 years, including this year, 97-23. They have lost 5 or fewer games in 12 of their last 14 years. And from 02 through 06, they had 4 straight 20-plus win seasons. They went 85-18 over that span of time. Both free throws by Cohlmeyer is good. She had to wait till overtime, Jane, to get anything going. She did not score in the regulation period of this game.
She looks like a little more relaxed here in the overtime for sure.
And now a 9-point lead, far and away the biggest lead of the game. And the clock winding down to a minute 12 to play here in overtime.
Memorial stays in that man-to-man. They don't play a lot of man-to-man, but BC's really had trouble with it.
He'll fire the three, miss the three. Ball comes up into the hands of Ladd. Central has only 2 points in the overtime. Those were free throws by Caitlin Tolan just moments ago. And you can feel the air kind of going out of this Benton Central crowd. It's a good crowd,
yeah,
but you can feel it going out of there. The foul is going to be on Gatterberg, and that'll be four on hers. Here's this run that really was impressive for Evansville Memorial.
Well, that's what started at the Sarah Stone three. Not known as a three-point shooter, but she knocks it down. She gets a layup, misses it, but the putback by Hackert. And now you're going to see Hackert to Ladd on an easy two-foot layup. That's how they've been able to score the ball very effectively in the overtime.
Stone hits the first of the one and one. Got them both.
Now, part of it is they've been fouling, BC has, to stop the clock. But in this overtime right now, Evansville Memorial leads on a 13-2 run.
Stone now with 13. Long range three by Tolan is good. She has all five of their points in OT. 44 seconds to play. Does Benton Central have anything left in the tank? We'll get a foul called right in front of us here on Hillary Moore, and that's going to be five on her.
Well, she had to do it. Time running down. Somebody had to step up, and she was just trying to make a play. Hillary Moore, very emotional. One of the seniors on this team, and she's had a terrific career as a Bison Lady basketball player. You see her right there going hard after the ball because she's got to make the foul.
She finishes with a double-double. 10 points, 12 rebounds.
She's going to have a terrific career at IPFW.
Well, when she comes back, she'll know right where the locker rooms are, won't she?
Yes, sir.
Hey, right, Indiana, Purdue, Fort Wayne has done a nice job. Dane Fife's done a real nice job with the men's team up here. And, of course, they have a NBDL team, an NBA Development League team that plays here in the Coliseum. At the line, Cohlmeyer. Four out of four. They've all been in overtime. This took her a while to get on track. And the lead at nine again. They could get it to double digits right here.
Well, they've Memorial is definitely an overtime team. They've outscored Benton Central with this free throw, 15-5 in the overtime.
The final score is going to be really not indicative. We'll get a timeout. You're watching the state finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and the IHSAA Champions Television Network. First time in the state finals history that the 3A championship game has gone to overtime, and right now it is all Evansville Memorial. We're talking about Sarah Stone who kind of started things off. She missed four early games with a shoulder injury. Goalkeeper on Memorial's 2008 soccer state champs. And she's heading to IU to become a Division I goalkeeper in soccer down there. She's been a key player, not necessarily scoring-wise in this game, though she does have 13 points.
Well, and they were clutch baskets. Remember, she hits a couple threes that they really needed.
Wide open shot missed that time by Cassidy Deno. That's at least a half a dozen open shots we've seen on both ends of the court, where you could just see that the rhythm was not there.
Boy, Deno takes it strong to the basket. It's just what you want. When you're down this much, you either get a wide open standalone jump shot three, or you get something going to the basket. She just couldn't get it to go down.
27 and a half seconds remain of the ball game at overtime. It's going to be Evansville Memorial picking up a state championship. They'll stay right with it, though, and get the bucket from Erin Cobb. Cobb getting her first field goal in the OT. 5 points altogether, and a quick foul call against Benton Central. And the foul will be against Reddick. That'll be the first of the ball game on her. Evansville Memorial has won 13 overall state championships in every sport. They've also won 15 medal attitude awards. A few years back, Jennifer Ballback won the girls basketball medal attitude award back in 06. Now here comes subs from everywhere as the coaches do what they normally do. David Baxter sending in a bunch of young ladies who will get a taste of a state championship
game. Absolutely. And you get to bring the team off the floor and give them the ovation they deserve on both ends of the benches, the winning side and the runner-up side.
Yep.
Not losers for sure,
but
weren't runners-up.
And we will have the Mental Attitude Award ceremony for you as Hackert knocks them both down. JJ will be out and talk with the Mental Attitude Award winner and the coaches. This is the first state championship for Memorial. They were the runners-up in 06, Bruce Dockery. That time lost 65-54 to Fort Wayne Lures. Basket that time from Caleb Tolan, and that's going to be your ball game. So we'll take a quick break and come back with the post-game activities. The final score is 58 for Memorial and 50 for Benton Central. Congrats to Evansville Memorial, 3A state champions. You're watching the IHSA Girls Basketball State Finals. It's presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, and it's on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Well, there's your final score in overtime. The Evansville Memorial Tigers finish up the year 28-1. Benton Central loses for only the second time all year. They are 23-2, and they are the runners-up for the state championship in Class 3A. And a quick observation, Jane and I were just looking at the stat monitor here. The rebounds were really spread out really well for Evansville Memorial.
Well, they out-rebounded the Bison 43-26. And they had three double-figure rebounders. That's just total domination on the boards. Anna Hackert had 13, Marie Hackert had 10, and Mallory Ladd had 13. Two of those three had double-doubles because Anna Hackert had 12 points to go along with her 13 boards, and of course Ladd was the leading scorer for Memorial with 24.
Well, we talked about Hackert. Marie did, she scored only 1 point the entire game, but was big off the boards, and it was a major part of this basketball game. So Memorial wins it 58-50. Time for we pick up the Patricia Elroy Mental Attitude Award. Let's head back across the floor and pick up the PA announcer, Scott Gray.
We would first like to welcome Mr. John Alexander, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance Agents, from manager from Fort Wayne, to assist with the presentation of the 2011 Patricia Elroy Mental Attitude Award for Class 3A Girls Basketball. Welcome, John. A Mental Attitude Award is presented in each of the 20 IHSAA sports. This award is based on scholarship, mental attitude, leadership, and athletic ability. In addition to the award, the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance Agents, a proud corporate partner of the IHSAA, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Since 1989, over $707,000 in college scholarships have been presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance to deserving high school students in our state. On behalf of the IHSAA, please join us in saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for its generous support of our student athletes. After I announce the name of the recipient, I invite her and her parents to join her on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2011 Patricia Elroy Mental Attitude Award for Class 3A Girls Basketball is Hillary Moore from Benton Central High School.
Hillary intends to study agriculture and business administration at Indiana Purdue Fort Wayne beginning next fall. Daughter of Rick and Shelley Moore of Otterbein. As we're presented, of course, by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Annually to the senior participant.
$1,000 to Benton Central High School. This money will be added to the general scholarship fund in the name of Hillary Moore. Thank you again, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Congratulations, Hillary, and Benton Central High School.
Hillary ranks at the top 10% of her senior class academically, served as a vice president and secretary of the school's Future Farmers of America, member of the National Honor Society. She's a 10-year 4-H club member, part of the Junior Leaders Organization. It goes on and on and on. A terrific representative for the Medal Attitude Award, Hillary Moore of Benton Central. Down to JJ.
Here with Bruce Dockery, head coach of the victorious Evansville Memorial Tigers. That has a nice ring to it, I'm sure, for you. What was the difference in overtime?
Well, I've always said in overtime, team gets off to the best start, usually in high school, has the most success. And we got off to a tremendous start, getting the opening tip and Sarah Stone hitting the three. And then we got a couple inside shots. And we had a couple of really good defensive stops. And I think the overtime period won in about the first minute 45.
There was a critical point midway through the fourth quarter. I listened to your huddle. You were down three, and you're like, you guys are in good shape. You kind of instilled some confidence to keep them from wavering, and quickly turnover and four quick points, and you have the lead.
You know, this is what's been a great group. It's why I enjoy coaching them. They don't get rattled, and they keep me more calm than I probably keep them calm, but they're a good group.
How's that appendix?
Blood appendix.
That's right, Jerry. Congratulations, Coach.
All right, thank you, JJ, and thank you, head coach Mr. Dockery, who's got to be feeling pretty good after going through the mental anguish and physical anguish he's gone through over the past week. Final score again in overtime, Evansville Memorial 58, Benton Central 50 for the Class 3A championship. You're watching live the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Hillary Moore. Jenna Deno. Marie Gadabert. Alyssa Briette. Assistant coach Carter Morgan. Assistant coach Bob Feimster. Assistant coach Carly Butler. Assistant coach Pat Cole. Your head coach, David Baxter. Assistant athletic director, BJ Gartenman. Assistant principal, Corey Robb. Athletic director, Jim Puckett. Principal, Destin Haas. Superintendent Dr. William Glentzner. And now the presentation of the runner-up trophy and game ball presented by Deborah Watson of Fort Wayne Snyder High School. Dear 2011 Class 3A runner-up, Benton Central Bison.
Well, these are not easy times. When you have fought your heart out,
yeah,
and you end up as the runner-up, and I was looking out at the Medal Attitude Award winner, Hillary Moore of BC, and likewise, it's difficult for her. It's a happy moment, but it's a sad moment.
Well, she's very deserving, a great young lady who's had a terrific basketball career, but she's a competitor. She wants to win. That's what it's all about. It's about the team and not about her individual.
And let's get a word from Hillary with JJ.
Here with the only senior for Benton Central, Hillary Moore, also the Mental Attitude Award. And you look at the stat line, an impressive performance in your final game, 10 points, 12 rebounds, 6 block shots, and the mental attitude. I know you wanted the blue ribbon, but still a fantastic day for you.
You know, we played our hardest. We said we weren't coming out with any regrets. None of us have regrets. We all left it out on the court. We played together, and our team motto was together, and we did that tonight.
Rick, can you put this night in perspective from a parent?
It's been a culmination of the last 4 years. I'm just looking forward to the next 4 years. We should be on the home team on this floor.
I was going to say that. It's not a bad trip. You know the way now, Mom.
We're just proud, you know? We're proud of her for all her accomplishments and proud of the whole team today.
Congratulations on all your success and best luck in the future on this very court for IPFW.
Thank you.
Garrett.
Jeremiah Johnson talking to our Mental Attitude Award winner. Not easy to carry your shoulders and head high after a situation like that, but I know it's trite, but they have nothing to be ashamed of.
Right.
10 points, 12 rebounds for Hillary Moore. Caitlin Tolan was the top scorer for Benton Central with 16, and she had 7 of those, by the way, in overtime. And then 13 points out of Cassidy Deno for the Benton Central Bison. For Evansville Memorial, 3 players in double figures. Mallory Ladd, 24 points, 13 boards. Anna Hackert had 12 points, 13 rebounds. Sarah Stone, 13 points. Marie Hackert only had 1 point of the game, but as Jane pointed out, she had 10 rebounds. So they had 3 players in double figures rebounding-wise, 13 each for Mallory Ladd and Anna Hackert, and 10 for Marie Hackert. Jane, at what point of the game, and you referenced the timeout, what point of the game did Evansville Memorial really start to take over this contest?
Well, I think really when it was 36-31, they were down 5. Coach Dockery calls a timeout, and BC came back and finished a free throw. But from that point on, it was Evansville Memorial until the end of the game. They went on a 9-3 run, and that fueled their overtime. They just kept that big momentum rolling into it. And BC gave up a fight, a hard-fought battle by both teams, but Evansville Memorial prevailed in the end.
Let's go back and pick up Scott Gregg on the PA. They have just introduced Bruce Dockery with hands held high in the air, and why not?
Now the presentation of the championship trophy and game ball to your Class 3A champion, Evansville Memorial Tigers, presented by Joe Santa of Warsaw High School.
I mentioned that Memorial now has 14 overall state championships. Benton Central picked up the Mental Attitude Award. That was their first ever in any sport. And for Memorial now, their first ever girls basketball championship. I mentioned they were runners-up in 06. Lures beat them 65-54. Finished the year 23-5 under Bruce Dockery. This school was originally put together back in 1922. Francis Joseph Wrights pledged money for the original Memorial High School. Prominent local financier. Listen to what he demanded. It's back in 22.
Uh-huh.
A location accessible by streetcar and near light, gas, and water lines.
Well, sure. Who wouldn't want that, Jerry? Come on.
For his $1 million gift. Think of this. In 1922, $1 million.
That's a chunk of change.
Yes, Wrights was presented with the insignia of Knight and Knight Commander of Order of Pius the Ninth. So great story about this terrific institution. And it makes that long trip. What did I say? How many miles did I say that
over
was?
Over 300.
300 and 310, yeah. So it makes the trip worthwhile. We'll come back with interviews following this particular game and get set for the 4A championship game likewise. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance on the IHSAA Champions Television Network.
Back here with David Baxter, head coach of Benton Central. The Bison come up short in overtime, and I know that has to be disappointing, but when you talked before the game, you wanted to match them physicality, and you were physical, but maybe the rebounding, is that maybe where the game was lost for you?
I think that was part of it. I'm really proud of our girls, the effort and intensity and heart that they displayed. It is disheartening they really had their sights set on winning a state championship, but I can't fault their effort at all. I'm really pleased with their effort tonight, and I'm just proud of them.
I think we deserve to say you're proud of all those fans. I mean, they'd lifted you up throughout time and time again in this game. It looked like this entire section was green and yellow as loud as they were.
Absolutely. They really just pushed the girls to limits that they probably aren't used to going. But you're right, the offensive rebounding was a big factor in the game. And then you got to give your hat to Stone. She hit, I thought, some really big jump shots out there, particularly that three-pointer in overtime. But like I said, I'm just really proud of our team and our community back to 100%. And hopefully we can get back here in the near future.
Well, young team, congrats on this success, and maybe we'll see you down the line again.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
All right. We'll be back. Let's now take one short timeout. A little hear from one of our sponsors.
Final score, 58-50 with Evansville Memorial in overtime and a whale of a battle in this basketball game. The shooting, which was so bad early on, kind of shaped up a little better toward the end. Evansville Memorial shot 16 of 49 for 33%. And Benton Central shot 33%, likewise 16 of 49. And Jane, these are two clubs that we commented on that are very good clubs as far as shooting was concerned. And yet it just wasn't there tonight. And I go back to what we said a couple of times. Defense played a big, big part of that.
It really did. Two defensive styles. Evansville Memorial played zone defense most of the game. And they really forced Benton Central into some bad shots. But on the other side, BC played man-to-man early on. And they forced Memorial into bad shots. So a very hard-fought game all the way through. Neither team shot the ball as well as they're used to. But in the end, I thought both teams really kind of adjusted nicely, and it was a great basketball game.
Well, one of the key players in this game is heading down toward JJ right now for Evansville Memorial. Mallory Ladd finished up, played 36 minutes in this game, had 24 total points and 13 rebounds, 11 off the defensive board. JJ?
Mallory Ladd lived a childhood dream, I'm sure, to cut down the net at a state championship game. You've got it in your hand. Describe your emotions right now.
Oh, I'm just excited and thrilled. It's every child's dream, and I've been working this since I've touched a basketball, so I'm excited.
It's been a great season, and you knew maybe there was a little bit of pressure to perform on this big stage. Both teams a little nervous early, but you got into your flow, 24 points, 13 rebounds.
Yeah, I just try to relax, and I try to get everyone else to relax and have fun out there and just calm down, so we tried to do that.
We've enjoyed talking to Coach Dockery throughout the game, and talk about what this week was like with him going through what he had to go through and look like the same old coach tonight.
Oh, yes, we had our ups and downs all week. We didn't know who was coaching us, who was going to lead practice, and we just had to take some initiative as seniors and just run the practice and work hard. So hopefully it paid off, and it did.
Mallory Ladd, congratulations on your championship
you.
And your spectacular Thank season, you. And best of luck in college.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Jarrett?
You know, it's interesting. It kind of runs in the family. Mallory's father played football at Kentucky, University of Kentucky, and her mother played basketball at Southern Indiana. So it kind of all fits together there. We will take a break. We're going to start getting ready for the 4A championship game. Penn and Jeffersonville waiting in the wings. There's your final score in OT. You're watching the IHSAA Girls Basketball State Finals, all presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and the IHSAA Champions Television Network.